Hello there, warm welcome to Proactive London. Michael Infante is joining us today from One Media IP Group because you've reported a jump in your revenue. You've said you expect a supportive market backdrop as well to continue in this environment. So you've got revenues increasing 13% in the 6 months ending the 30th of April 2022 to £2.4 million. This is compared to the year before. You've put this down to new acquisitions, organic growth, and active management of your portfolio as well. So I want to break all those points down and much, much more. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Nice to see you on this sunny day.
Nice to see you this hot day. Right, so let's get an idea as to how you're getting on. So you've named a few things there, but just generally, before we dig into the detail and get underneath the layers here, how do you feel about it all?
We're very, very pleased with the results for the half year. I think in the face of economic climates, we look around at other stocks that are suffering. And I think once again, this is beginning to prove that music is a robust investment. I think the area that we're in, which isn't subject to fashion, we're in the nostalgic area of music from the 60s, 70s and 80s. It's our sort of prime hunting ground for acquisitions. Our business generally is performing, as far as we're concerned, in line and slightly ahead, perhaps, of the market. I think 13%, I think our music industry, it depends where you take your figures from, but anything from 7 to 11% seems to be growth areas. I think an increase in our EBITDA by 39%, I think, is healthy. I think our margin increasing to 67%, you know, we've made a few strategic acquisitions this year where we haven't increased our turnover, but what we've done is we've bought out royalty paying licensors to us. And that, of course, means that we've bought out their side of their royalty. So our turnover was the same because we were representing them before. And as my father used to say, you know, profit is sanity, turnover vanity. I know that that's an old fashioned saying, but I think in times of tough, and we are in a bear market at the moment, I think profit is important. We've had some good news within the industry as well that we'll touch on in a moment. Yep. And I think generally speaking here, we still have a strong pipeline and we're still driving forward.
Yeah, and you mentioned that industry news there as well. I want to mention, so positive industry developments in the US, which should increase the royalty rate to 15.1% from 10.5%. And this is following the copyright royalty brand ruling in July.
Correct. This is an argument that's been going along for since 2018. The industry, when you go back to the physical world of CDs and LPs, the royalty rates for publishing were all set amongst those physical rates. So as the world went digital, these things haven't moved along. They've now been adjusted. It's a five-year deal from 2018 to 2022 inclusive. That takes it up by 44% effectively from 10.1% to 15%. Now, from One Media's perspective, most of our income is still derived from royalties of recordings. So materially, this won't make a huge difference to us on our back catalogue. We do have some publishing and composition rights, clearly, but we're not as perhaps reliant on those as perhaps some of the bigger firms that are out there that have made some big announcements. However, it is good. And as I think I said earlier, it's a check-in, not a check-out, which is always good. Talk is now carrying on with the CRB. They want to see these rates at 20%. And I can remember in 2018, when these discussions first started, they wanted to see it at 30%. But I think in the next 5 years, to get to 20 is probably not unrealistic. So this is all good news for the industry at large, and indeed for composers and artists alike.
All right. And we've been catching up throughout the year. Maybe tell us a bit more about your new acquisitions and how they've been implemented.
In the half year that's under review, we bought the Orbital Rapier catalogue, which is a big bag of mixed recordings, right actually in our normal catchment of the sort of areas that we were working, music from 60s, 70s, 80s. Now, we bought the income. We didn't buy the underlining copyright. So it's an in perpetuity deal. So we're very happy with that. We can then look back at some of the other deals that we've done over the course of the year. They're all obviously public and on our website. So I think today what I'd like to really cover at length is two or three things within the music industry and within our industry. It's getting an understanding of where strategically One Media sits and what it does. And we are a content buying business. Now, you've heard us talk excitedly about our TCAT operations, and TCAT is now an individual business. We are currently seeking funds to make it a more independent business, to get the money straight into TCAT so that it can grow and follow its own path. There's a very competent team over there that are building the business, working with three major record labels, and One Media will be a all-time client of TCAT, and it uses its technology to help us in our acquisitions, to assist us in policing our own content. But we do see ourselves as being a customer of it longer term, rather than owning it. So that's all going on, and we're very pleased with the progress that we're making there.
All right, and how do you feel that you're being perceived by the market right now?
I think scale always is something that eludes One Media, and we do need to grow. We understand that. I think we're growing from a very strong foundation. I've been doing some analytical stats based on how we compare to some of the much larger companies that we not necessarily compete with, but certainly are within our sector. And I think those stats are very positive to us. Scale is really important. We have to grow to be an AIM company and to be a public company. We must, you know, move our business forward. But we are in challenging times. We don't want to overgear. We don't want to do things that could potentially put the business at risk, specifically with, you know, strong results in our half year. But we're always minded that pipeline is important, scale is important, and what we need to do is to grow this business.
All right. And how do you plan to do that in a nutshell?
I think probably the most important thing is to look at acquisitions and the way that we work. I think we have a very, very good model in the way that we won't overpay on multiples, and we have to keep those multiples down. Our yields are looking good, and we're sort of looking at the way that we structure finance moving forward and the way that we will finance some of these deals. Our share price sadly isn't reflective necessarily of, we think, of the value. We had our catalogue revalued. It sits at 14 million on our balance sheet, came in from YMNU at 34.5 million on a very conservative multiple. So we have assets within the business that just aren't being recognized. So our challenge is to build on that and to make sure that we can leverage what we have and move the business forward.
All right, Michael, we'll leave it there. Thank you so very much indeed for taking the
time. Thank you very much.
Thank you to us. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.